Hello and welcome to a slightly serious, slightly somber episode of 420 Grams here on newsclick.in. I'm joined in the studio by Ishfaq Ahmed and Vaibhav Raghunandan, and we're talking about India's exit last night at Sharjah from the AFC Asian Cup 2019. So close yet so far for India. Last minute penalty, I mean stoppage time penalty, guys. Heartbreaking.
Well, to be very honest, I didn't like the way they played the second half. If you, Bahrain was playing really good. Kind of, you were expecting something will happen. They were, really brave. Gurpreet made a couple of really good saves. But that penalty, kind of when you defend so deep, you feel like that's coming. And that's what exactly happened, one ball, too many players inside the box and one missed challenge or missed tackle, you say. Maybe tired legs also that time. And once your body is tired, you don't think properly whether he should have gone out or wait for the ball. But yeah, I'm very disappointed with especially with the second half, and even talking to some of the players, everyone was, I feel like, Bahrain, well-deserved.
Do you agree with that assessment? A realistic sort of result given where Indian football stands right now?
I don't know if it's where Indian football stands right now, but it's definitely, he's right in the sense that it was coming. Yes, it's a little harsh to say that this is basically what we deserved, because we deserved a little more than this. They had stood out for a large part of the the UAE game and performed really well in the second half against Thailand. But yesterday, you could see it coming. There were 3-4 minutes even before the goal. Gurpreet made one fantastic save. Then it bounced off the post. Then there was some last-ditch pinball happening in the box. You could see heartbreak on the horizon.
You could see it coming, yeah. Going into the tournament, when we did our previews, when we assessed the squad that Stephen Constantine had picked to go to the Asian Cup, we had hoped that we were wrong, of course, but we did say that in the group, India are the weakest team. And as things have gone, although we got that massive win against Thailand, the 4-1 win in the opening game, which kind of, I think, elevated everyone's expectations. All of a sudden, fans were thinking, man, there's something completely different going on, right? This is a new look India team. For those who come in when these big tournaments, big games happen, and they see a performance like the Thailand game, the enthusiasm levels go off the chart, but we did end up becoming the first team to exit the tournament. Is that fair, Ishfaq? Do you think that the Indian boys got what they deserved out of the tournament?
Not really. I won't say that. They beat one of the very talented team, Thai team. I think they deserved more. At least they deserved the third spot. Mm-hmm. If you compare, like, immaturely, like a fan, you behave like we beat Thai beat Bahrain, but still we didn't qualify. But I think they played really good football first match, especially the second half, as he was mentioning. Really, really good football. They pressed high and they looked dominant in that match. They played excellent 40 minutes against UAE. First half, 40 minutes, got couple of really great chances. Obviously expectation will be, high. That's normal. That's very normal. But I think somewhere, there was tactical blunders also. I feel we should have not made any change. Gone with that, winning team, which most of the coaches do. I think they had enough rest. And as we all know, the average age of the team right now is 25-26. Yeah. So I don't think four days is more than enough.
We'll get into tactical parts of the game and Stephen Constantine's decisions before the game as well as during the game in a minute. Before that, you might have noticed that Arjun Pandit is not here with us today, because as soon as India exited from the Asian Cup, he exited the football scene. So he's gone over to the dark side, which is Indian cricket. But of course we did manage to track him down. So Pandit, do you generally agree with that assessment, in your opinion, of what Ishfaq and Vaibhav and I think of how the sort of tournament progressed for India?
Hey Siddhant, hey Ishfaq, sorry guys, couldn't join you directly for the show because busy at work. Just got done with it, man. One reaction to the game, disappointing, man. Honestly, disappointing. Whoever you speak to, very, very disappointing reaction. We didn't even manage a single shot at goal. Yeah. I mean, in the first two games, all that we had done, and you know, the way we had attacked UAE, the way we attacked Thailand, we saw nothing of it. Now, was it a game plan? Was it something that the boys were told that don't go ahead, just make sure you're protecting goal, that should be your first move? We don't really know, but irrespective, it wasn't a pleasant sight to watch. And truth be told, it reminded me a little bit of the India of old, you know, when all 11 were behind the ball, attacking, defending. As soon as you get the ball, you've already lost composure, man, because you've only set up to defend. So when you have the ball, you're like, arre, ab main kya karu? And there were so many moments of that. So I would say disappointing.
Okay, so that's Pandit's take. And Pandit, stay with us, yeah, because we'll come back. We'll talk more about the tactical elements, because the other bit of big news, of course, was immediately after the final whistle at the post-match press conference, where Constantine, without making any bones about it, said that my time, I've gone through the cycle that I had to go through with India. My time here is done. I've left the players in a better position than when I came. And now it's time for me to move on, right?
I don't think he's wrong. You know, like if you remember, when he started, we were like, I think 167 FIFA ranking, somewhere
173 maybe.
173, somewhere around that. You know, like they did well. They qualified. You know, it's a different thing if we talk about, like, a lot of fans are talking about the format of the tournament change, that's why. But come on, you have to still beat other teams. You know, it's not easy to beat in football. It's not like to be easy to beat Nepal also. It's not Cricket World Cup. It's like everyone is playing and everyone is improving.
Yeah.
And, you know, like we have, in fact, Indian national team have shown that once we beat Thailand also. And UAE coach mentioning, you know, like who is one of the top coaches right now in Asia. He mentioned that India has a great team and they will definitely progress in next Asia Cup. Mm-hmm. So, which is a really, really good positive for to, you know, like take with them. I think if you talk about his contract, about Constantine's contract, he had mentioned it. He want to stay till, and I think AFF had given him till Asia Cup. Because he made them qualify, he was the boss, and he deserved this chance. And we saw a different Indian team, definitely. I personally feel the fitness was the biggest plus point which I have seen.
Actually, I think you can circle this back also, like, with in terms of talking about Constantine, where you can, obviously, results are what essentially eventually matter in football, but you should not base a team's progression, a team's trajectory, just based on results. You also have to see, are they playing better? Has the standard of football itself improved from when, say, Constantine took over to now? And that's the question to be asked. Like, in this Asian Cup, despite the fact that we may have finished bottom of the group, you saw some bits that were really good. You saw some kids who were really good and who will be Indian football's future. You saw some guys cement their places and make sure that they're going to be there for the long haul. Yeah. So these are also, I think, topics to, like, sort of consider when you think about this failed Asian Cup campaign, if you want to put it like that.
I guess that there was some agreement on that, okay, 4 years he's been here, it's his second stint. Things on the ground are not changing as rapidly as it might appear from the outside in terms of how Indian teams can be sort of prepared to play, what sort of style we can play. I mean, there were also comments on shows that we've done in the past saying India should play tiki-taka football. You know,
it's not realistic to expect that.
Elements aside, credit has to be given to Stephen Constantine for many things, and particularly, like we've talked about many times, for the chances that he's given to younger players to experience and become a part of the national setup. Do you agree, Ishfaq?
I think definitely he is one coach, you know, like I played under him, I think when he was 10 years back, a decade year back. His philosophy is based on bringing up, you know, giving new players a chance, and these young guys somehow they do very well under him. I do understand, you know, like fans' emotion and sentiments, like we should play a more attractive football and all that. But sometimes he coaches also, right? You need that that kind of players, you know. But we do have players, you know. Like I feel like it for our nation, it should be a mix of position and the direct football. Direct football is not bad. It's like if playing, you know, we play direct football against a Thai team. Thailand, we press them high and immediately long ball a couple of times from even Gurpreet, which was very effective. We use the speed. We have a player who love to run. So direct football may suit them. But yeah, at times we need to have that ball control, which I know everybody is talking about. And maybe yeah, it's the right time to bring some new coach who can
bringing that change into the system. Because apart from everything else, having the ball also ends up giving the team a bit of a breather.
Absolutely.
You're less intense when you're chasing, when you have possession.
Which is what was missing yesterday.
Absolutely.
In the game.
Especially as the game wore on.
As the game went on.
Yeah, so let's talk a little bit more in detail about the tactical elements of the decisions that Constantine made.
In his final game,
yeah. Whether it was the initial decision to play Raulin Borges instead of Anirudh Thapa, the change he made in terms of when Anas got injured, unfortunately, right at the beginning of the game, how he made a like-for-like change, bringing Salam Ranjan in, instead of perhaps reshuffling his back line a little bit. And then, of course, at halftime, he pulled Ashik off, who was the brightest spark along with Udanta, I think. And, of course, the defenders were doing really well. But in an attacking sense, Ashik was the bright spark for us today. So, to start this off, I want to go to Pandit before he runs away. You were in studio with Phil Brown, Eric, and of course Renedy Singh, and you were watching the game together. What did you guys make of these tactical decisions that the coach made in the game?
Yeah, bhai, you know, when we got to know about the team sheet before we were about to go on air, and in came Raulin in for Anirudh Thapa. Now, I first up went and said that maybe this boy is unfit, a little bit of fatigue is setting because he's already played 180 minutes of football. But Renedy was saying, no, brother, this is a tactical move because he has sacrificed the creativity of Thapa for the long legs and the defensive capabilities of a Raulin Borges. And that is exactly what he did. Even though in the pre-match press conference, he said, I am going in there to win and to get the 3 points. The way his team played, the way his team was set up, it did not appear like that. It seemed that he had set his team up to get that 1 point and make it into the knockout stage. Clearly, it backfired because, truth be told, Raulin did not have a very good game. Raulin, whenever he got the ball, he was misspraying the pass wherever, you know, a lot of missed passes he was making, and very unlike a Raulin performance. So yeah, so disappointing to see India put in such a defensive performance, especially after what they did versus UAE and Thailand.
Okay, so that was the assessment from the Star Sports studios. We've also learned, Ishfaq, that the changes were not necessarily a result of injuries. So everyone was available for selection. These were tactical decisions. Why would you play Raulin Borges ahead of Anirudh Thapa?
Well, I think that's the big question, you know, like everybody wants to know. But but if you see the Bahrain coach also mentioning it when he saw number 7 is not playing, and he immediately got this sense like, okay, they want to go for a draw. And he mentioned in his post-match conference, you know, like, teams do get ready. They do the post-mortem of the other teams and see where their strength lies. Thapa gives you more mobility in midfield, and what that allows, why it was working, Pranoy can stay a little bit behind,
back. And
Thapa can just express his football and go here and there, and then because Pranay and Thapa complements each other, and then because he recovers, he's fit player, and he comes back. And when you go with the two defensive midfielder, you know, like then Pranay comes out of bit his comfort zone, because when Borges is playing along with him, he's not that quick. Borges is kind of a game maker, but Unfortunately, he doesn't have that pace what he used to have. And in this kind of tournament, Asia Cup, where top teams are playing, where Bahrain, like, they are like playing, and all other top teams are playing, you need more fitter player, more faster player. Yeah. And we have seen all the top coaches have mentioned the speed of Indian team, which was our plus point, and which we unfortunately didn't have the in second half when the tactical changes you were talking about, there were no injuries. If somebody was telling me that coach I mentioned, he would Thapa had some
back injury.
Back injuries.
Yeah, I mean, Constantine had come out and he said that. But if that is the case,
then why he came in second half?
Why would you bring him on
at all?
There is Balwan. There is like apparently you have taken.
And I think when he brought him on out of position also. He brought him on instead of Nazri.
So that's again a question mark. Should we add one more winger player like Changte or Farooq, or maybe people, or as Renidhi Singh was saying other day, player like Sushiraj who can beat players. So that, you know, like, it's all, of course, had we qualified, we would have not been talking all this thing. You know, like, it's normal. Yeah,
I think we would have been talking about it, but maybe we would have been talking about it one game later.
Yeah, could have been that, but I agree. But to you know, like, these are valid questions, and they are like, you know, like, because I'm into coaching profession, so I know, like, I feel like they are errors, especially one big error which I felt like was changing Ashik. Ashik, only one guy, he looked very strong, you know, like very fast.
Yeah.
And once you remove the Ashik, then we don't have, you know, like that outcome for those long balls. Because what JJ can do is like only the ball should be aimed towards him, not away from him.
Yeah.
And it's very difficult when you are under such a tremendous pressure. To aim the JJ and
playing,
that didn't work.
Playing as a target man for JJ in an Indian context is very different from playing a target man at the Asian level also. And also tactically, I guess I want to bring in what we had said in our sort of earlier preview, that having Subhashish, Bose and Narayan Das in the squad only makes sense if they act as cover for each other and for the other defenders who are playing. And I thought that given that Anas has had a tough time with injury, there were question marks over him being match fit, A, match sharp.
He played well,
because
he defended solidly.
Because he didn't
because
play
he
much.
Played in
absolutely.
The ISL.
Yeah.
And then will he be able to suddenly handle the stress of these high pressure matches and keep it going for three matches back to back? So inevitably he broke down. And what we had assumed was that Subhashish will then move into a central role, and Narayan, because Narayan now has 30 odd caps for India. He's not an absolute newcomer. He has some experience. He's been with the squad for.
And that's why you have that
you
bench
have
strength.
You have the bench.
Yes. Yeah, so what is the point of what is the point of having, like you guys said, why replace a winger for a central midfield. Central predominantly central midfield
and
player?
Balwant also, you know.
You have these guys who are there only to make a late impact in a game. So I guess should be the end of that part, because we can go on talking about this for hours and hours, but it doesn't
Nobody
really
wants
fly.
To watch.
Nobody wants to watch. So I do have to ask you.
It's a positive critic. It's not like.
Yeah, yeah, of course. It's
question.
Not criticizing for. Yeah.
It's anybody can ask.
And so. Let's hope that perhaps some of these larger questions of team management perhaps will be looked at by whoever comes in next. On which note, I want to ask you, what kind of a coach do you think now India should be looking for? At least in, let's just put it in the short term between now and the end of the season.
Well, for me, like, we need a more manager than a coach right now. And I think Savio is the technical director, consulting with him also as well, what kind of national philosophy we should develop. And that is where we have to start from the grassroots. We can't just bring somebody for the national team and not keeping this in view, like the grassroots, what kind of players we're going to produce. Mm-hmm. I think we have to, this goes hand in hand. I think somebody who has a better vision for nation and what kind of philosophy suits us, I think that's the most important part. And I personally believe that we need somebody who has like vast experience, who has, you know, maybe somebody who have worked in Asia as well, to understand the players' mentality and players who are, you know, like what kind of Indian players are usually a bit soft. They don't go to speak to coach. I think somebody who can understand Indian football, somebody who can understand the nature of Indian players and give them more confidence by holding the ball, keeping the ball position sometimes, yeah. Not like
maybe expanding the scope of what we can do. Absolutely. A little bit. Gradually sort of pushing the envelope.
Just teaching them game management also.
Game management, yeah. I totally agree. This, that is the...
No, but important. I mean, so this will then go into a larger question of league mein kya ho raha hai. ना बिकॉज लीग से भी आप कुछ सीख के आते हैं तभी तो नेशनल टीम में कुछ बेनिफिट होगा
वही बोल रहा हूँ ना मैं मतलब
आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाट ही इज सेइंग एग्जैक्टली
फिलॉसफी ओवरऑल फिलॉसफी शुड बी यू नो लाइक हम लोग जो नेशनल फिलॉसफी वी हैव टू डिफाइन दैट फॉर
लाइक वी आरंट एट अ लेवल वेयर वी कैन जस्ट ब्रिंग इन अ कोच हु हैज सर्टेन फिलॉसफीज एंड देन एक्सपेक्ट आवर प्लेयर्स टू जस्ट गो एंड फिट हिज फिलॉसफी व्हाट वी नीड इज एसेंशियली अ गाय हु कैन परहैप्स look at what's available and then...
Fair enough. So, here's the next question and perhaps on this note, we'll start to wind up this episode but... And Ishfaq, you can choose not to comment on it because you are a coach, you are an Indian coach, so maybe there's a little bit of conflict for you. But let me ask you, do you think, and let me bring Pandit in as well, do you guys think that it makes sense to, at this stage, give the reins of the national team to an Indian coach? Because as much as it's important to develop and the team and get the results, it's also important to develop the national philosophy and to develop Indian coaches so that in the long run, coaches are also benefiting from the experience that the national team gives.
Absolutely. I mean, the problem with Indian sport as a whole is that you don't want to give your Indian managers or your Indian coaches a chance. You always want to constantly bring in some foreign input. You just assume that your players will get better if you bring in someone from outside. So definitely, I mean, it doesn't matter, sure. I don't know. Maybe we'll do much better in terms of results. Maybe we won't, but we should just be prepared to give
it a shot.
Absolutely.
But what Weber was saying, I think if we go to the, if we go statically for all the managers who have managed national team, Rahim Saab still has the best winning percentage.
Yeah.
You know, like if we go like that. But yes, I totally agree with him. Indian coaches, they have to, there should be a program for them also. Maybe right now you can bring a foreign coach, but all the age group teams should have Indian coaches. There are a lot of coaches who right now in coaching system who have represented country and played for a long time and
senior, like
yeah,
seasoned pros.
Absolutely, and they should be given chance. And we should have a program, coaching programs also, which coach education program we have. But we should have selected coaches to go exchange programs.
Absolutely.
So that they can get trained there and they bring those things rather than we bringing them here and
absolutely,
our coaches not learning anything.
What do you make of that, Pandit? Would you, for example, say okay, we're in the middle of a season, it's not perhaps the right time to be looking for a replacement immediately. Maybe someone can come in during the summer when, you know, the European clubs, etc., do their hiring and firing and chopping and changing. So would you give the reins to, for example, Venky for now and say, you know, let him have 3 months with the team, let's see where he goes?
My point is that the AIFF should quickly sit down on the table and finalize a coach as quickly as possible. Now the point is that you have 4 years to the next Asian Cup. Forget about the World Cup because we're not going to go very far in those qualifiers. My point is we're going to be playing in the Asian Cup every year now, or rather every edition, sorry, 24 team tournament, so we have a chance of making it. So you have a 4 year period to go one better than what you've done in 2019. New coach will come in, new coach will take time to assess the Indian conditions, the Indian players, our style of play, and then once he picks his players, on the basis of that, he should choose his style of play, right? He should choose a style of play. A lot of people have been a little critical of Stephen Constantine, but I kind of agree with his style of play. His style of play is something that suited our boys' capability. We don't really have too many boys who are very good on the ball, who have composure on the ball. There's a Sunil Chhetri, but beyond him, at the international level, how many of them really have composure on the ball? So you have to set up a team where you sit back and you absorb and hit them on the counter. So my advice to the AFF would be, just find a new coach as quickly as possible, find a good coach as quickly as possible, and give him the reins with at least 3.5 years before the Asian Cup.
So yeah, I'm glad you heard it as Wenki and not Wenger, because the guys were like, we don't mind bringing Arsene Wenger in to have a go with India and see where he takes us. But guys, thanks very much. I think that's a pretty good sort of assessment of how India's tournament has been. If any last words from you guys, if there's anything that you want to add to that, just maybe Ishfaq, a line on what the boys you spoke to sort of told you after the match.
Well, they are a bit disappointed, and they know that they didn't play to their potential, you know, like, but you were expecting, you know, I remember you talking in pre-match show also, you know, like the scenario of matches, you know, posed in such a way where India can go through with the draw also, and it automatically by nature of the game, like they will try to defend deep. But sometimes, you know, like that's the downfall also sometimes, and we have exactly seen what that pressure did to Indian team, and they somehow conceded that penalty kick in 91st minute, which was kind of heartbreaking actually. You know, like when you work hard 90 minutes, you know, like up and down, and then give a...
Especially for Pranay to give away that penalty after he'd played a real captain's innings, as it were, to use a cricketing term, because he'd had a fantastic game. I mean, covered superbly for the back line, so many interceptions, passing all right, intelligently. So yeah, so disappointing overall result for India. The team will be coming back, but the positive is that the sort of support that this Indian team had from the football community in India has been a massive step up from anything it's been in the past. So I guess the last word from our studio is, I hope that the fans will continue to be engaged with us as a part of this story and with Indian football in general. Keep tuning in, keep coming back. We'll see you soon.